The Apostle Paul gives you his testimony in 1 Timothy chapter number 1. Here's what it says. I thank Christ Jesus our Lord, who hath enabled me, for that he counted me faithful, putting me into the ministry, who was before a blasphemer and a persecutor and injurious, but I obtained mercy because I did it ignorantly in unbelief. And the grace of our Lord was exceeding abundant with faith and love, which is in Christ Jesus. This is a faithful saying and worthy of all acceptation, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am chief. Now watch this. Howbeit for this cause I obtain mercy, that in me first Jesus Christ might show forth all longsuffering for a pattern to them which should hereafter believe on him to life everlasting. And now he rejoices. He says, now unto the King eternal, immortal, invisible, the only wise God, be honor and glory forever and ever. Amen. What that means is that whoever you are and whatever you've done, the Lord Jesus Christ went to the cross and paid your sin debt so that you could be forgiven. And the Apostle Paul says, I'm a pattern for how he forgives anyone in the future. So what does he mean by that, preacher? He means this. He means that he was completely blinded in his religion, going away from God, and God came to him and showed him mercy. And when he showed him mercy, he said, if I, the chief of sinners, can receive the mercy of God, surely you can. Because he said, I'm a pattern for them that should hereafter believe on him. Isn't that wonderful? It's wonderful to know that your sins are forgiven through the finished work of the Lord Jesus Christ. You don't have to do anything. You don't have to pay any kind of a penance. It's all been done for you. And the Bible says that one time he offered a sacrifice for sins forever, and now he is set down at the right hand of the Father. And some of you out there are carrying an enormous burden. You're beaten to death every day of your life by Satan. He wears you out. I had a man tell me one time when he was in the military, he said he killed people in the military, fighting. But he said, preacher, he said, my mind goes back to that day, and he said, it wears me out. He said, Satan beats me to death for what I did. If the blood of Jesus Christ, God's Son, does not cleanse from all sin, then we're in trouble. Because who is to say what sin he does not cleanse? You? Some man? Some church? Is someone going to say to you, well, he'll forgive this, but he won't forgive that? I'm sorry. I'm glad that I've got the Word of God, the trust in Scripture that tells me that he'll forgive. Paul said in 1 Timothy, I was injurious. He was headed to Damascus with letters to the synagogues to take any that he found in that way, that was before they were called Christians, to take them bound back to Jerusalem and have them stoned to death. But he met God. Hallelujah to God. He met God. That's what I'm on here for. I want to help you meet God. I want to help you look above religion, experience, people, whatever else that may be standing between you and the Lord. And I want you to meet God. Let's pray. Father, for those that are listening to me right now, and Heavenly Father, feel that there is no hope for them, Lord God, make it very clear to them that the Apostle Paul is a good example for all of us, that though he was a murderer, that you forgave him, and that he becomes an example for everyone that should live after him, that can be freely forgiven through the finished work of our Lord Jesus Christ. In his holy name I pray, and amen. If you'll pray that prayer, if you'll mean that prayer, you'll find forgiveness. There is forgiveness at the cross. God bless you. I'll see you again.